Hey guys, and welcome. Today I'm going to tell you how to raise some of your own feeders. Now this is going to be very important because of certain circumstances going on now, but I'm going to show you how to do dubia roaches, superworms, mealworms, and even crickets. Starting off, I'm going to go off with dubia roaches. Now these, again, I like using, say, a 30-gallon tub. And what you do, you can take some sort of mesh or some sort of other breathable object, you cut a hole in the top and you put that in, and then any egg crates you may have, whether you get eggs or when you get the feeders in, you're going to want to use these as a main support for them to climb around and move. Now I'm going to show you a good heat source, any old heat pad, but again, you want to have heat for these guys because they are going to want to have some sort of heat source to be able to grow and thrive. And then I'm going to show you some pictures here of just different setups I have, and then me pulling up, showing you guys the breeders, and then I'm going to show you here towards the end just some of the little babies that you can get. And these guys are pretty reliable. Literally all you need is some carrots, some gut load, some other chow and other things, and you guys can have plenty of babies in no time. You can buy these all online and get them shipped to you and start. And again, another good source of a main protein source, especially for collared lizards, is the dubia roach. Now here next, I have the superworms for you. These are, again, ideally more of a snack, but definitely easier to keep long term. Dubia roaches, again, they can breed and you can have them just sitting around, but superworms, you can keep them in a cool room and they just sit there for a long time. If you do want to breed them, I'm going to show you some strategies that you can actually set them up in cups, because they stay stimulated when you keep them together and they won't pupate out into beetles. I'm going to show you putting them into cups, letting them sit. They'll actually pupate and you'll get the adults, and then you can put them on an oat sort of meal chow with some carrots, gut load, and other greens to get them really to be happy and breed properly. And I'll show you here just a container of some of the superworms that I've grown here at Colorful Collared Lizard Ranch. And again, more of a snack, but need be for certain circumstances, you can use them for a good protein source to keep your collared lizards going. And again, here is just a simple thing that gets different temperature ranges you want to keep them in, and just how to keep them really healthy and happy. Moving on next, I'm going to have mealworms. Again, another smaller type of beetle, so I'm going to show you again just a way to keep the adults, keep them breeding. There's different bin systems. You can use tubs, you can use a 10-gallon tank, 20-gallon tank, you can use a 5-gallon bucket, if you have a lid or breathable lid or a screen top to it. Pretty much allow the mealworms to fall down and you just sift them out whenever you need them. So again, I can just run through my hands through here and pull out baby mealworms if I want. As well, I'll also show you a cup that I have where you can see multiple different sizes of mealworms, from little ones that were just born to other ones that, again, eat on these different food choices, nutritional things, and you can kind of gut load these too to have higher ratios of nutrients if you want them, higher proteins if you give them like a protein meal. I actually use some fish pellets that are high in protein that you can literally just throw in there and they'll munch on, just to help keep them healthy as well, keep them hydrated, and again have another long-term source of food where you can keep these in room temperature or somewhere cool in your basement in a closet, and these guys can not pupate and last for a really long time in case you do need a food source that you can grow at home and keep for reliable. Again, these are more of a snack than a main source of food, but need be, these can be a staple for your collared lizard, bearded dragon, anything you have. You can grow them, keep them happy and healthy. And again, here's just different temperature ranges to make sure that your mealworms are living happy and healthy, and other protocols to follow by. Next, I'm moving on to crickets. I'm going to show you, I keep these again in a big 30-gallon tub, and I have gut load here, some with high vitamin A. You can use other ones. You can use ones that are just high in water and fluids to keep them maintained. You can throw in oranges, you can throw in potatoes and other things, but again, these are 4-week old crickets, and just some more crickets here in the container. I dust them this way, so you just drop them in the container, dust them, and then they're ready to go to be fed. This is another main source of food for your collared lizards or any of the other pure insectivores, and good protein ratio for these guys. You can again gut load them to have good ratios of other food. But another one, a little bit harder, I would say, to actually breed and grow and maintain. But you can order these in, and again, if you do need something that you need long term, I would suggest either the dubia roaches first because they're a good main food source, superworms and mealworms next because you can get the beetles and have your own breeding group going on just to be able, especially someone who only has one lizard, two lizards, you know, having a 10-gallon tank with these growing in it, you're not going to have to go to the store, get out of the house to buy some of these feeders. So again, another good way. And here is an example of many parameters that you can follow to maintain proper health, proper housing, food, and water for these crickets. And again, you can buy these, get them shipped to your door, literally box straight to your door, live animal box. You open them up, put them right in the tub. Here's a box for crickets, mealworms come in this, superworms come in the same thing. Now here's some food sources. Again, another important thing, go through Cheerios, oats, just another high fiber nutritional. Here's rolled oats, you can do fiber grains. That's fish pellet feed. And again, showing you guys, just throwing in greens, carrots, other things. You see some gut loads, some of the pellets, some other stuff. Give them moisture, give them, you know, fruits, other things that they like. I'm going to have a list right here for you guys coming up soon that just goes through a bunch of different feeds that you can do. Again, just don't do anything that might be toxic, one to the insect, but also to your lizard. And again, try to maintain hydration, protein, any supplementation and a gut load that you do want to feed, and just something that'll help these guys thrive and really progress and do well. Again, I can't harp enough on just maintaining these guys and growing them, just have a supply in case things do come up. And again, different things that you can have, there's so many different choices of food out there.